Dear students, in the last class we already discussed the flowcharts, algorithm and some programming constructs. Okay, so there are three types of programming constructs. The first one is sequences or sequential constructs. The second one is selection constructs. Third one is iteration or looping constructs. Okay, so we already know that what is sequential construct. So sequential construct means, so step by step you have to write the solution for the given problem. Means in the algorithm the first step is start, in the second step you have to give the input, in the third step we have to compute, in the fourth step you have to print, and finally you have to stop. Means whatever you have to mention the step, it must be clear one after the another. Okay, so that is considered as a sequential construct. So selection construct means it consists of some types, that is if statement, if then else statement, if else if then else statement, nested if and multiple selection. So that is a switch statement. Okay, so here selection means, so selecting from the alternative. The condition is true, it will execute the particular statement. If the condition is not true, again it will execute another statement. So that is the five categories are comes under the selection construct. And the third one is iteration or looping construct means, so again it consists of three types. First one is while, do while, so last one is for. The main purpose of using the iteration or looping construct is, so more than one time the statements will be executed. So whatever the statements you are defined in the particular construct, so that can be executed repeatedly until the condition becomes false. For example, in the if condition, if A is greater than B, see out. So here you have to mention A is large. Okay. So first it will check the condition. If the condition is true, so directly it will execute the statements. After executing the statement, automatically the if statement will be terminated. It will terminated means the end of the if statement. But if you are using iteration or looping statement means, again the condition is true, the statements will be executed. After executing the statements, again it will check the condition. For example, so just I can write while. So while, yesterday I already told syntax. Yeah. While I is less than or equal to 5, C out I is equal to I plus 1. Or so print of I is equal to I plus 1. So initially I is equal to 1. See here. First it will check the condition, 1 is less than or equal to 5, condition is true. If the condition is true means it will print the result as 1. Next is I is equal to I plus 1, 1 plus 1, 2. 2 means again new value of I is 2, 2 is less than or equal to 5, again condition is true, next it will print 2. Next I become 3, next it will check, next it will print 3, next I become 4, next it will check, next I become 5. Then the I value becomes 6, 6 is less than or equal to 5, the condition becomes false. The condition is false means automatically it will come out of the loop and it will execute the remaining statement if the statements are present. Okay, so here iteration or looping construct means the statements, the repeatedly statements will be executed until the condition becomes false. So ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಫಾಲ್ಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತಾನೋ ಎಕ್ಸಿಕ್ಯೂಟ್ ಆಗ್ತಾವ್ರಿ. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಫಾಲ್ಸ್ ಯಾರು ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕ್ರಿ? ದೋಸ್ ಹೂ ಆರ್ ರೈಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್, ದೇ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೈಟ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಟು ಬಿಕಮ್ ದ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಫಾಲ್ಸ್. ಸಿ ಹಿಯರ್, ಇನಿಷಿಯಲಿ ಐ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 1, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ 2, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ 3, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ 4, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ 5. ಸೊ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದಟ್ ಐ ಬಿಕಮ್ 6. ಕೆ ಯು ಥಿಂಕ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೈಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್? ಸೊ ದೆನ್ ಹೌ ಟು ಥಿಂಕ್? Okay, the given question is to print the number from 1 to 5. So we have two values, one is initial value and one is final value. So in between we have to print the value from 2 to 4. Okay. Initially we have a value that is I is equal to 1 and 1 is there. Here 5 is there. You have to compare these two values. 1 is less than or equal to 5. Next you have to print. So after that here 1 is there. Next I have to print 2. If I want to print 2 means just I can add 1 to the given value. That's why I can write I is equal to I plus 1. Next time it become 2. Next time if I add another 1 means it become 3. Next 4. Next 5. Next 6. And the I value reaches to the 6. Obviously the condition become false. Okay. So this is nothing but the while constraint. So second one is do while. So it is similar to the while, but only the difference is, so this while is pre-tested or entry controlled. So pre-tested or entry controlled means first it will check the condition, next it will execute the statements. Do while means it is a post-tested or exit controlled. So exit controlled means, so first you can write do, here you can mention the statements. So after that you can close the brace, next you can write the condition, while condition. So it is exactly opposite to the while. So whatever the statements present in these two brackets, these two statements can be mentioned in do, like this. Do first print I, next I is equal to I plus 1. So after that here you can write the while I is less than or equal to 5. So exactly opposite, exit control loop. Exit control means last, in the last step you can mention the condition. So that's why we call it as a exit control loop or post tested loop, while and do while. So last one is for loop. So again it is similar to the while, but only the difference is it consists of one general format or syntax. See here. For bracket initialization condition increment or decrement here you have to mention statement. See here, just a second, write one example. The same example can be converted to for loop. See here, initialization means initial value to be assigned. If you want to take the program of to print the number from 1 to 5, so here we have to take the initial value as 1. So why we have to take the initial value as a 1 means the given question is like this: to print the number from 1 to 10 or 1 to n. N means user entered limit. So for just I can write I is equal to 1. Here, see here, initialization is done. Next is condition. So how to write the condition? Same, I is less than or equal to 5. Next is I plus 1. See here, increment or decrement. Yeah, or you can write I is equal to I plus 1. Instead of writing like this, you have to mention here, and within the for loop just you can print I. So this is also same, this is also same, and this is also same. So both are, all the three programs gives the same result, only the difference is way of writing the syntax. If you are using the while construct in that general format, in that syntax it does not tell that we have to initialize. Okay, but according to the for loop, first step is always initialization. Compulsory we have to initialize. After that we have to check the condition. See here, first it will run I is equal to 1 is stored in I. Next it will check 1 is less than or equal to 5 is. Next it will print I 1. So after printing I is equal to I plus 1 will be executed. So it looks like I equal to 1, I less than or equal to 5, I equal to I plus 1, not like this. After checking the condition, it will execute print of I. It will print the value. After printing, I will be incremented. Incremented means increased by 1. I become 2. Next, it will check the condition. Again, it will not execute. Initialization. 2 is less than or equal to 5. Again, same procedure. It will print 2. Next, I become 3. 3 is less than or equal to 5. 3, 4, 5. Then the I value becomes 6. 6 is less than or equal to 5. The condition becomes false. Okay. Again, these constructs will come in the programming concept. Okay, in the program problem solving methodologies, so you have to learn some basics. So you will get some ideas about how to construct the program. So what actually the programming consists of. Okay, but in detail it will come in the upcoming chapters. Okay, but in this chapter, so in this concept you have to remember is, so what are the programming constructs? There are three types of programming constructs. First one is sequential, second one is selection, third one is looping or iterative. So other than programming constructs, so we already studied the algorithms, flowcharts. So these two are very very important. Algorithm means it is a step by step procedure to solve the problem. So whatever we have to write the solution for the given problem, so we can represent it, we can represent with some diagrams. So that is nothing but the flowchart. That is a diagrammatic representation of algorithm. Okay. Next is characteristics of good program. Characteristics of good program. So characteristics of good program. So first one is, there are two characteristics. First one is modification. Modification. Second one is portability. Portability or portable. Portable. Okay. So first one is modification. So here modification means the program. Okay, whatever we have to write the program, it allows that program or the programming concept will allows the user to modify the program. For example, if I write print of A, actually it is print of I, but by mistake I have to return different. Or again you can modify the existing statement. That program will allow, that programming language will allow the user to modify the program. Or suppose if you want to add, initially I can write C is equal to A plus B. So after that if you want to add subtraction also, again it will allow B is equal to A minus B. So easily you can modify the programming concept, easily you can modify the programming statement. So that is the one characteristics of good program. Portable. Portable means easily transferable. If I write the program in system 1, so that system can be easily transferred to the second system. Just you can copy and paste. Otherwise you can mail to the another one. Okay. So portable means transferable. So these two are the characteristics of good program. So next is approaches of programming language or approaches of program solving. Approaches of problem solving. Problem solving.
approaches of problem solving.
So first one is top down design. It is important for 2 marks, 1 mark. Top down design or top down approach. So first one is top down approach. So here top down design or top down approach means the program. Suppose if the program is a complex one, for example it consists of 200 line programs. Okay, top down approach means the large program is divided into the sub program. The large program is divided into the sub problem. Suppose if the problem is complex, you can divide this problem in sub way. The entire problem, first you can consider the problem, next you can consider the program. Okay, if the problem is complex means we can divide the problems. In a given question there are n number of problems will be there. We have to solve n number of problems in one question. Okay, if the problem is complex means we can divide the problem in sub problems. We can divide the entire problem. It divides, it gives some separate parts. It means that sub problem 1, sub problem 2, sub problem 3, sub problem 4. Again these sub problems are further divided into another sub problem. So how many times you can divide until you will get the solution? Until you will get the solution on the complex problem anna now divide madkonta hodanga. So now elli thana divide madbekappa antandre, so we will get the solution for that problem. Alli mutana now problem anna divide madkonta hodanga. That is nothing but the top down approach. If the problem, it is related to the problem. In the same way program, the entire program is divided into the sub program. Again the sub program is further divided into another sub program. Unless that, until you will get the solution for that, you can divide that concept, you can divide that program. So that is nothing but the top down approach. Top down approach. So we can start with the big and end with the small. Okay. The process of dividing the problem into the sub problem. The process of dividing the problem into the sub problem, unless that, until you will get the solution. So that is nothing but the stepwise refinement. Stepwise refinement. Again, it is same top-down approach or stepwise refinement. So top-down approach is also nothing but the stepwise refinement. So here top-down approach means the large problem is divided into the sub-problem. Again, the sub-problem is further divided into another sub-problem, unless and until you will get the solution for that. Here also same stepwise refinement. Okay. For example, see here, just I will draw one diagram. A, B, C. Here A is the main problem. So this problem is divided into two sub problems B and C. So B and C is again further divided into B and C again further divided into D. Here E, here F. Again it will not divide sub problems. So because in the D, in the I, in the F you will get the solution. Once the main problem is divided into B and C, you will not get the solution. So that's why again it will divide. Again further it will be divided D and I. Again it will divide F. So here you will get the solution, means step by step you will get the solution for that. Here you will get the solution, means obliterated you get the solution for B. And finally you have to solve main problem. Okay, so that is nothing but the top down approach. Next one is bottom up approach. Bottom up approach. Again, the concept is similar here, but only the solution is, it is exactly reverse of the top down approach. So top down means from top to the down. So bottom up approach means from down to the top. So usually, so top down and bottom up refers to the programming languages. The example for top down approach programming languages are C. Here bottom up approaches are C++ and Java. So why C is called as a top down approach, means the execution of the program, you have to run the program from top to the down. In C++ and Java, so we have to execute the program from down to the top. So why in C++ and Java we have to execute from down to the top, means because it consists of some object concept. In generally object means any things. Okay, so each program consists of one function, that is main function. Okay, see in C++ and Java, so the main function should be written in last, but in C main function should be written in first. So that's why it is the top down approach and these two are the bottom up approach. And how to define the main function and how to write the program, so it will come clearly in the next chapters. Okay, but here you have to remember one thing is, top down means dividing from top to the down, bottom up approach means from down to top it will execute. So these two are the approaches of the programming, approaches of problem solving. Okay, next, next is modules. So here modules are nothing but the functions. Again it is similar to the sub-programs. The entire program is divided into the sub-program. That sub-program is nothing but the modules. So here modules are also called as sub-programs. Sub-programs or functions. Functions. Sub-programs or functions. Okay. So modules or functions or sub-programs, all use the same meaning. Okay, so why we have to use the function, why we have to use the sub programs, why we have to use the models. Suppose if you are writing the 200 lines of one program, suppose if the error will occur, means you can concentrate on the entire program, you can concentrate on 200 lines. Suppose if it is dividing, this problem program is divided into sub parts, that is 50 lines. Okay, suppose if the this is module 1, module 2, module 3 and module 4. If the error will occur in module 1, means programmer or user can concentrate only on the module 1, not the module 2, module 3, module 4. The main advantage of using the modules, sub programs or function is easy to understand the program, easy to write the program, easy to handle the errors. easy to handle the errors. Okay, that is the main advantage of using the models. Okay, in the next class, so we will discuss the some programming constructs. That is structured programming, object-oriented programming, and procedure-oriented programming. Okay, thank you.